Morning, everyone. Thank you for being with us. I'd like to introduce you to Akiko Matsumoto, who is going to be our presenter for today. And she's going to speak on 5 reasons that you should never eat whole wheat.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Mary. And thank you for coming today. Thank you to give me a chance to have a lecture today. So today, I explain 5 reasons that you should never eat. So today's concepts are relationship of wheat, blood sugar, and insulin. And the leaky gut syndrome. Have you ever heard leaky gut syndrome?
Yeah.
Here, the destroyed gut barrier because of wheat. Or, of course, because of heavy metal or other toxins. But today I will speak about wheat. So first, let me introduce myself. I'm a doctor of internal medicine. Since 1992 in Japan, specialized in intestine and liver. So I worked like 15 years in Japan. So now I'm here and coaching nutrition and lifestyle.
This is a certification of the
medical doctor in Japan. I wrote some books and I have a YouTube channel. Are you familiar with modern disease? Allergy, such as eczema, asthma, hay fever, food allergy, cancer, a lot of kind of cancer, and metabolic syndromes such as heart disease, hypertension, diabetes, hyperlipidemia, osteoporosis, and depression, or autism, or some other mental disease. And also autoimmune disease, such as rheumatoid arthritis or Hashimoto disease. There are so many modern diseases, but like modern 1,000 years ago, there were no such kind of disease. One root cause of modern disease are destroyed intestinal barrier and damaged gut cell with toxin, such as bad foods, mental stress, inappropriate sleep, or medicines. Of course, inappropriate exercise. So once barrier is destroyed, carcinogens or allergens are absorbed into the bloodstream. At the same time, nutrients cannot be absorbed. So in time, you get disease such as osteoporosis or anemia, cancer, allergy, and so on. Because of the toxins and malnutrition, we should protect our gut barrier. To protect our gut barrier, everything is important, such as how to eat, like how many times you chew, what time do you eat, or how feel when you eat is really important, and also what to eat, appropriate sleep and exercise, and also control mental and physical stress. One way is, of course, meditation. It's very important. But it's difficult to change all, so not easy to change diet, because you should think about food only when you eat, or only when you buy, or only when you order at the restaurant. So it's easy to change your diet. So which is easier to become healthy? What do you think? Eat good food or eliminate bad foods? B, yeah, both, but B is more easier. Because prevention is better than treatment. To eat good food is like a treatment, but eliminate bad food is like a prevention. But there are so many bad ingredients such as MSG. Do you know MSG?
Yes. Yes.
And pesticide, high fructose corn syrup, preservatives, artificial colors, fertilizers, commercial vegetable oil, commercial cow milk, and also GMOs. There's so many GMOs in here, in the United States, and also in Japan, because we imported a lot of foods from here. But wheat is one of the worst foods. And also, even if organic, whole wheat or handmade, it's not healthy. There's 5 reasons that wheat is not so good. Because one, raised blood sugar level. And second, gluten intolerance. And third, anti-nutrients such as folic acid or proteinase inhibitor. These are only exist in whole grain. White bread doesn't include antinutrients such as folic acid or proteinase inhibitor. Proteinase inhibitor is disturb our proteinase and we cannot digest protein well. Folic acid disturb mineral absorption. Folic acid wants to take minerals from our body. If you eat a lot of folic acid for a long time, you will become mineral deficiency such as anemia or osteoporosis. So it's very important to know what whole grain has. Not only the wheat, all the whole grain has some such anti-nutrients because they want to protect themselves from insects or animals like a predator. So usually seeds has a lot of toxins. Folic acid and proteinase inhibitor is one kind of toxin. Of course, the wheat germ agglutinin, it's kind of toxin, break our cell membrane, and it's cause of break the gut barrier. That's why the wheat has morphine-like effect. It's called proteomorphine. It's almost same like morphine. So first, wheat raises blood sugar level. Blood sugar level and insulin for the cycle. Wheat raises blood sugar level. It's then become high. And high blood sugar level promotes glycation, cause of disease and aging. Have you ever heard glycation? No. Have you ever heard oxidation? You know?
Yeah.
So glycation is the same idea such as oxidation, but a little difference. Glycation is the proteins and glucose bound tightly, and we can't metabolize. When the proteins become old, like skin, usually we can metabolize and we chlorinate old one and make new one. But the glucose and the protein bind tightly, it's difficult to metabolize. So we cannot throw away and we cannot make new one. It's a kind of one reason to get the wrinkle, cataract, because of nephropathy of the diabetes or retinopathy of diabetes. Anyway, it's same like oxidation. So too much glycation is really bad for health. High blood sugar increase insulin level. And insulin promote hypertension, inflammation, cancer, or other disease. Glucose and insulin make you fat. Yours not so fat, but most of the people in here in Peoria, it's so much of it. So most of them eat grains like bread, pizza, pasta, sugary drinks. So many say that whole grain is a good grain. So they eat a lot of whole grain and get more fat and get more disease. So it's a stupid idea, but it's a... So please imagine what happens when you eat. So first, food goes into your stomach and mixed with digestive fluid. Then it goes to small intestine and digested more. And after food breaks into small pieces, food goes into your bloodstream. And then the nutrients go into your whole body. So let's see what happens when you eat grains. Pizza, glucose, main one is insulin. Grains are digested into small pieces. And when you finish digestion of the grain, at the same time, just a second, the glucose are transferred to the bloodstream. This is raised blood sugar level. And next, pancreas releases insulin to transport glucose from bloodstream to organs, such as brain or skin or liver. We call this down blood sugar level. Blood sugar doesn't disappear, just transport from bloodstream to organs. Blood sugar transport to organs such as brain and heart. And glucose are consumed inside organs, in each organs. But if you eat a lot of grains, the carryover glucose are stretched as body fat. This is why eat grains become more fatter.
That's provided you don't burn it off, correct? Because you can burn, you need glucose too. That's the first fuel your body uses to burn when you exercise.
Before exercise, it's okay to eat a little more. But usually, fatty people eat
too
more grains.
Too much.
Yeah.
They don't exist.
They don't exist.
Yeah. They don't exist. It's almost the same idea that when healthy people eat less grains, these are glucose and insulin. This is the blood sugar level, and this is insulin level. When you have meal, blood sugar level becomes higher than hunger, but not so much. Pancreas releases insulin, blood sugar transport to other organs, and the sugar level decreases like hunger level. So blood sugar level is not so dramatically changed, just stable in a narrow zone from like 80 to 110 milligrams per deciliter. When you have a blood test, probably the doctor asks, is the hunger or after you eat or timing to have a blood test is really important about blood sugar. When we eat more grains, the blood sugar level becomes high and insulin released a lot. And the blood sugar level decreases down because too much insulin transport too fast to organs. So it becomes blood sugar level becomes down, and lower than hunger level, and you get hungry again. And if you don't eat, too low blood sugar level is very, very dangerous for the body. The hormones like cortisol or adrenaline are released from the adrenal, and blood sugar level becomes up. Blood sugar level becomes super low. We call reactive hypoglycemia. Most of the people have a kind of feel like this. I ate just now, but still I'm hungry, or I have enough space for dessert. It's become hypoglycemia. If you don't eat grains, you can feel satiety, but if you eat grains, you always become hungry. I have a lot of feeling when I was a college student. I ate a lot of apple pies, ate potato chips, like a big bag, and until the end. So I couldn't stop. When I finished, I want to eat again. Absolutely, I had a reactive hypoglycemia.
So that's the issue with wheat. Is the same thing true of oats?
Yeah, oats. Do you know the GI, the glycemic index?
Glycemic index?
The oats glycemic index is like around 60. Of course, it's less than wheat, but oats raise blood sugar level a little high. For diabetes people, I can recommend oats. I don't eat so much.
You need carbs.
We need carbs, but we can from vegetables or fruits. So we don't have to eat grains. Before the agricultural revolution, people never eat grains.
What about rice?
Rice also raises the blood sugar level high.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. I love rice and also my small one loves rice, but I can't recommend. I eat sometimes, just once in a month or something like that. So if you love sushi, just eat fish, not rice.
So what about these ancient grains that get talked about? The quinoa.
Yeah, ancient grains, spelt wheat or something. Yeah, they also have some problems of gluten, but less gluten than modern gluten.
Well, actually, wheat wasn't too bad until they started hybridizing it and increasing the amount of chemicals in it.
Right.
Yeah.
And the genetic amount of it. Because people weren't obese 50 years ago. Uh-huh. So I think that the change has been in agriculture.
After the Green Revolution, like such as 1950s, wheat or also corn changed. So they need a lot of fertilizer and pesticide. The rice is the same. They need a lot of fertilizer and pesticide. So, and also rice has arsenic. Even if it's organic, rice has arsenic than other grains. So to avoid it, it's better.
Okay, cool. What about like there's a lot of talk about sprouted grains,
sprouted grain,
like
but also they have gluten doesn't appear, so I can't recommend even if it's sprouted. If it's sprouted, the proteinase inhibitor or phytic acid will disappear or decrease. So,
but the gluten doesn't disappear.
But gluten doesn't. So only oat doesn't have gluten.
I think you're saying that oat does have gluten.
Oat doesn't, but oat has a little different toxins. The CARS is called alpha-aminopectin. It's a chain of glucose, and it's very easy to digest.
Break it down into sugars,
yeah.
Right.
The wheat is worse than table sugar. You know about it? This is the glycemic index. Everyone knows glycemic index?
Mm-hmm.
Or? No? Okay. The glycemic index is a relative ranking of carbs in foods according to how they affect blood sugar levels. The carbs with high glycemic index, such as over 60, like the red one, are more rapidly digested, absorbed, and metabolized, and cause of a higher and faster rise in blood sugar, and therefore insulin levels. Whole wheat bread is higher than table sugar. Most of the people know sugar is not so good, but the whole wheat bread is worse than table sugar. Because of alpha-aminopectin, the grains have alpha-aminopectin, it's change of glucose. So there are so many glucose inside the grains. Insulin effect, like insulin transfer blood sugar from bloodstream to organs, because of that lowered blood sugar. Also, insulin make muscles.
No.
Insulin stimulates.
Insulin gives you the energy to use.
Use or rebuild muscles.
Right.
Yeah.
But you need the protein to make those.
Yeah, of course.
It's in a bad shape.
Insulin has other effects to stimulate making body fat, to disturb to using from body fat, and aging, especially some researchers said brain aging and raise blood pressure level, increase inflammation and cancer cell. So much bad effect insulin has. When you eat grains, we need a lot of insulin and also bad effect of insulin. So to optimal health, of course we need insulin, but not so much level, just a low level. Researchers say that elderly healthy people has low level of insulin when they are hungry. Also when they eat, even if it's grain, they don't make so much insulin. Because among healthy people, insulin effect is really good, so they don't need so much insulin. But obese people has a lot of belly fat. Insulin doesn't affect well, especially from transfer blood sugar. They need a lot of insulin to lower the blood sugar level, but the insulin doesn't affect well. So they need a lot of insulin. We call insulin resistance. Have you ever heard insulin resistance? This is the first step to have diabetes. Because of so many insulin, they have a aging or blood pressure level high or inflammation such as arthritis or asthma. Also, cancer cell loves sugar and insulin stimulate cancer cell. If you have a cancer, you never eat grains or sugars. Could you stand up and rest? Sitting too much is very bad for health. Please stand up at home once at 1 hour. I usually use a PC with standing. Next, I will explain leaky gut syndrome and gluten intolerance. Gluten intolerance is like a destroyed intestinal mucosa and absorb toxins and not absorb nutrients. It's one of root causes of many diseases. Gluten breaks gut barrier. This is leaky gut. And gut cannot flow away toxins. And gut cannot digest well and cannot absorb nutrients. Absorbing toxins go into organs such as brain, heart, liver, breast, bone, or others. So because of that, malnutrition. And it is related to so many morbidities such as fatigue, depression, Alzheimer's disease, irritable bowel syndrome, osteoporosis, diabetes, hypertension, obesity, hyperlipidemia, hay fever, arthritis, colon cancer, breast cancer, especially colon cancer and breast cancer is really related to leaky gut syndrome. And the researcher said that from 8% to 50% of United States people have gluten intolerance. Just Jack Chalin, he said that from 8 to 50%, almost half of United States people have gluten, may have gluten intolerance. How many symptoms do you have? Can you count constipation, diarrhea, heartburn, dry skin, tiredness, stomatitis, cleaner asthma such as allergy, autoimmune disease, brain fog, depression, headache, also cancer, too much love for pasta, pizza. So one, two, three, four, did you count that? Five, six, four, six, seven, eight, zero? Zero? Oh, that's great. Five? Great, okay. Before I explain the Rigida syndrome, I explained intestinal anatomy and function. So, of course you know that gut digests good and absorbs nutrients. Have you ever seen your gut? No? I did. The gut shape is kind of vacuum for capillary vessels, like a small vessels network, like a spider web around the gut, inside gut, like chimney made of bricks. There's a mucus and bacteria, the same idea with cluster. Bricks is like a gut cell, and the joint between the bricks is like a cellular space. So please imagine that the chimney. There are three ways that wheat destroy gut function. So excessive glucose destroy barrier because it increases bad bacteria. You may know that we have a good bacteria, and also the not good, not bad, but when we have a good bacteria a lot, some bacteria acts like good bacteria. So there are three kinds of bacteria. Of course, so many kinds of bacteria. Bad one loves sugar. So if we eat plains, the bad one increases a lot. The total number of bacteria is almost same all the time. So just when there's a lot of bad bacteria, good one has no space to stay, so they decrease. Second, gluten loses tight junction and makes space between cells. Small intestine cell and also large intestine cells. We have a lot of cells like this. And there's a tight junction, like a staging. Gluten makes tight junction loosen. They make cellular space. So the toxin and also undigested food easy to come inside the bloodstream. With other grains has lectin that destroys cell membranes. So there's three reasons that they destroy gut barrier. Intestine is like a tube, cut intestine. There's a lumen here. The food is around here. These are intestinal cells. Violet one is tight junction. Intestine has some vessels. The good particle like this in digested foods or bacteria or toxins or virus are not absorbed and just becomes two. Digested nutrients such as amino acid or glucose or vitamins or minerals are absorbed and go into the intestinal cells and go into the bloodstream. This process is absorption, but when we eat wheat, because of the lectin or bad bacteria, destroy intestinal cells, and also gluten loosen tight junction like this. So the toxin or bacteria or heavy metal are easily to absorb, go through the intestinal cells because of that. Permeability is higher, easy to go to bloodstream and then go to your organs. And also because of the function is bad, the minerals or digested food cannot absorb well. So this is a leaky gut.
If a person stops eating gluten-rich foods, does the system repair itself?
Yeah, of course. Because the intestinal cells cannot absorb more nutrients, so you become sick. People, when toxins are absorbed, they go to organs such as kidney, lung, liver, skin, lung, everywhere. So it makes inflammation in each organs. That's cause of such kind of disease. Also, the rice doesn't have gluten, better than wheat, but also they have lectin. It's less than wheat lectin. I can recommend so many grains. Compare the wheat, it's much better. Easy to keep. We don't have to refrigerate. So for 10,000 years, human eating grains all over the world. Mm-hmm. But before agriculture revolution, there's no grain. Researchers said that Stone Age people didn't eat grains, and also they don't have cancer or diabetes or hypertension, such as disease. 2,000 years ago, like Roman Empire war, they already had their gout or diabetes because they eat a lot of grains. Like, of course, not like us, and also they work hard. The metabolic disease are already studied at that time because of grains. Wheat attack gut barrier and gut cells. This is one major root cause of all the disease. People say that whole grain is healthy because they have a lot of fiber, minerals. Mm-hmm. But of course, grains store the pesticide on the outside. All, not only grains. Of course, the apples has a lot of pesticide on the outside. Actually, apple is always number one fruit because of the pesticide. The apple needs a lot of pesticide. So every year, upward has a
residual.
Yeah, pesticide. Always number one. So if when you eat apples, it is not organic, please peel. Outside, there's a lot of pesticide. So whole grain has more pesticide than white one. And also, bland has anti-nutrients such as phytic acid or proteinase inhibitor that makes poor digestion and bad absorption. Even organic whole grain have anti-nutrients. Even in high mineral or fiber, such as phytic acid and proteinase inhibitor, because of that, human cannot digest and absorb well. If you want to have some vitamins or minerals, you can eat vegetables or fruits. Don't expect whole grains to have fiber or minerals. Actually, it goes on mineral deficiency, such as anemia or osteoporosis or tooth canal because lack of mineral. Generally speaking, plant-based nutrients is difficult to digest. The animals can run from predator, but plants cannot move, so they protect themselves from predator to make toxins. The fruit is the only one designed to be eaten. Also, veggie leaf has some toxins. Polyphenol is kind of toxin from protect by ultraviolet or insects or something. Small quantity of polyphenol makes us healthy because when we eat polyphenol, our body makes some antioxidant or something like this. A lot of polyphenol doesn't good for us, but a little polyphenol such as grapes or a little wine is good for our health. Anyway, plants cannot move, so they have some toxins to protect themselves. Bran is high fiber, it's correct, but the most of the fiber is water insoluble fiber, so clean your intestine. But to feed your bacteria, water soluble fiber is okay, but not water insoluble fiber. So water insoluble fiber, such as bran, is just clean your colon. Like sometimes it's like scratching your colon or intestine. There's two kinds of fiber. More important is water soluble fiber. They are included by like fruits or starchy potatoes. That's sweet potatoes or pumpkin or something like this. So if you want to eat fiber, please choose water soluble one. Prebiotics. Prebiotics is the food of the bacteria. Five reasons that we should never eat whole wheat. So wheat raises blood sugar rapidly and increases insulin level. And insulin drops blood sugar rapidly and makes hunger again. both cause increase for bad bacteria and decrease good bacteria. This is one reason of BD gut syndrome. And gluten loosens tight junction and makes space between cells. This is also leaky gut. And the wheat is not organic. It has a lot of pesticides and fertilizers on the outside. So whole grain is worse because of folic acid and proteinase inhibitor. Gluten has a molten-like effect. When we digest gluten, a little digested and become gluten molten. And the shape is almost same like morphine. When you have a leaky gut, the gluten morphine go into your bloodstream and also go into your brain. Stimulate brain to feel happy or a little dependent. So same like morphine, the people who used naloxone, it is antagonist, opposite effect of morphine. Naloxone blocks the morphine effect. There's a study of people who used antagonist of morphine in naloxone. When they took naloxone, people didn't eat so much. The people who took naloxone eat 500 less than usual. Probably gluten morphine is one reason of autoimmune disease such as rheumatoid arthritis. When people took naloxone, the autoimmune disease's symptom is a little better than usual. The wheat has so many toxins, there's no reason to eat wheat. If you don't want to get such a disease, just change diet, vegetables, fruits, and also tree nuts is okay. And also, meat, especially organ meat, has a lot of vitamins, such as liver, kidney. They have a lot of vitamin B, vitamin A, vitamin E. So I recommend to eat liver or kidney. Especially in winter, we don't have sunlight enough, lack of vitamin D. And vitamin D is very essential vitamins for human. To take some supplement or eat liver or kidney is better, especially in winter.
What should vegetarians eat?
Strictly vegetarian, usually should take some vitamin B12 or vitamin D because of the lack of vitamins. Yeah.
How are they supposed to get the protein if they don't eat greens? Vegetables?
Meat. There's a lot of vegetables you can get from meat.
They don't eat meat if they're vegetarian.
Because of that, I can recommend this again. If they don't take some supplements, absolutely they become sick. Vegetables have some protein, but it's just a little, and also it's difficult to digest.
Fish.
Fish is okay.
Turkey.
Yeah. Turkey is of course okay.
And chicken.
Of course.
But you're not recommending any milk products in your ear, are you?
If it's organic, sheep or cheese. Goat, it's too good.
Goat cheese, okay.
Yeah.
Goat milk?
Yeah, goat milk is okay. Yeah, really good. Okay. But cow's milk depends on what kinds of cow. Most of the United States cow is Holstein, like a white and black spot one. Has a beta-casein A1, cause of some disease such as hypertension or diabetes. So commercial cow's milk, I cannot recommend. Even if it's organic, so if you really want to drink cow's milk, please go to the farm from the grass-fed
mm-hmm.
milk.
Grass.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Grass-fed and goat's milk. I drink both of those.
Yeah. If you can get from the farm, not
pasteurized.
It's even better. Yeah. Which is really tasty. A different taste from cows.
Yeah.
But anyway, sheep and goat milk is absolutely better than commercial cow's milk. If you have a daily product, please choose good yogurt or cheese. They at least yogurt has a lot of probiotics. Mm-hmm. It might be better than just milk. Be careful to other ingredients such as
sugar.
Be careful if you quit wheat suddenly, you will have withdrawal syndrome, a headache, irritable cravings, or others. So take it slowly.
Do you ever eat wheat?
Ah, of course. My husband loves pizza, so once in a month or once in 2 months, we go to Brienzo at the junction city. After I eat pizza, I always become hungry, and I want like eat like a raspberry, fruits. Because of too much salt, my body needs potassium.
Potassium.
Yeah. So I ate and I get 2 pounds in 1 day.
Yeah, water absorption.
Yeah. I have a lot of gas after I ate pizza, and like 2 days, and make me back. I feel like my bacteria changed dramatically inside my tummy. Feel like this.
Are there any health problems related to eating meat or amount of meat?
The quality of meat.
That's according to the World Health Organization, red meat is toxic.
They don't say about the quality of the meat. Most of the meat fed GMO corns, and they stay in a narrow space, they don't have any light, they don't have to move, they eating. If meat, such kind of that is absolutely bad. It's almost like a metabolic cow. How can we be healthy when we eat such a cow?
So you look for grass-fed or organic chicken or
at least
grass-fed
organic
meat.
I don't eat red meat myself.
I do because I need the iron.
I ate a lot of meat, but absolutely organic. And I'm still searching which farm is okay. To buy from direct farm is it's better. But sometimes it's difficult, or sometimes I'm lazy to go to farm. I often buy from broker.
Yeah.
But at least they say that grass fed.
That's right.
Yeah.
And they have naturally oriented
too. Oh yeah. So
I can't stand the meat if it doesn't smell good meat.
I love it.
But fish is okay.
My husband had a heart attack, and that was the first thing they said.
Well, it's kind of
the red meat.
It's like she said, the kind of good to eat.
Yeah. He could have it once in a while, but not a lot.
The first is wheat. Also grains, not only wheat. The grains raise the LDL cholesterol level and makes triglycerides, that's cause of heart attack. Please reduce grain first.
And sugar.
And sugar.
People are drinking their sodas every day.
And
they're sugar-laden caffeine drinks.
I always about sugar because I don't have sugar.
Whole wheat sugar is in everything.
I know.
You have to be careful what you
have to read.
And also,
read every label.
Such as safflower oil or sunflower oil, soy oil.
What oils do you want?
So cooking, butter.
Yeah.
And
butter too. How about olive oil? Olive oil?
For like a dressing, I use olive.
But
the olive oil is a little weak than butter. So I also recommend for heating or cooking. So to put on the salad,
With it at low temperature.
Okay. Just a little or low temperature is okay. And also coconut oil.
If you're not allergic to coconuts.
And avocado oil. For cooking, butter is and ghee. I never use ghee, but ghee is also strong. So I recommend butter.
It goes against the American Heart Association.
The Heart Association will say that saturated fat is not so bad. They will say. They start to say saturated fat.
Not as bad as trans fat.
Of course, trans fat and also too much omega-6. Such as soy oil, or sunflower oil,
safflower
oil, cottonseed oil.
What do you think of soy products, like tofu, miso, and tempeh, and all that stuff? Is that?
Tofu is a little different, but miso and tempeh also. Natto, do you know natto? It's a fermented soybeans. It's okay to a lot of good bacteria inside, also a lot of good prebiotics inside. But be careful that most of the soybeans is GMO.
Oh, it's GMO. So, gotta get organic.
Yeah.
How about soy milk? Is that okay?
Soybean is the same idea with whole grain.
Oh.
They have a lot of phytic acid and proteinase inhibitor. So I don't recommend.
Okay.
Yes. And there are so many nutrients, anti-nutrients. So soy is a seed, so same idea with whole grain. Seeds should protect themselves, not to eat by animals.
How about more nuts protect themselves then too?
Nuts has a little phytic acid, but less. So it's okay to eat.
I like nuts.
Yeah.
Yeah, I love nuts.
Me too.
But too many nuts, I can't recommend. Nuts has unsaturated fats such as omega-3, but it's a little weak. The unsaturated fat is easy to oxidate. The best way to eat nuts is just put in the water for more than 7 hours. We can decrease anti-nutrients soaked into the water 1 night or 1 day, and you can eat. Taste is a little
soggy.
Yeah.
I can't cashew, but it doesn't good. So just walnuts or almonds. Yeah. Let's say don't buy me nuts today.
Did I get this right? Oatmeal is not good to eat.
Oatmeal?
Oatmeal.
I eat it every day and for years. Me too.
It's much better than wheat. But if you want to lose belly fat, I can recommend. If you consume,
I don't need any. I don't need wheat.
Young people, like such as teenager or something, they need a lot of energy.
Yeah.
So it's okay to eat a lot. But our generation, I don't recommend so much.
If you're active, you need something like
just after.
And
wheat, eat,
oats are better than wheat, so I start my day with oats. I need the energy. I'm gonna
it's okay,
do
of course.
A workout. I need it.
Yeah, when you go for it, it's okay. But I recommend more fruits in the morning.
Oh, fruits have a lot of sugar.
Yeah, fruits have a lot of sugar.
Well.
Yeah, but fruits have also
natural sugars.
Antioxidant or fibers.
Some sugar with my oat. Some. Berries with the oatmeal is fine.
So berry and kiwi and grapefruits has less sugar. So
kiwi and what?
Kiwi and grapefruits.
Grapefruit, okay.
Yeah.
They don't go good on oatmeal.
Hmm?
blueberries go wonderful.
Yeah.
Strawberries.
Yeah, blueberries. Yeah,
strawberries.
Wonderful.
Organic
strawberries. Organic strawberries, yes.
Yeah.
Organic blueberries.
Yeah, blueberry and strawberry has a lot of pesticide, so
yeah,
you should
buy more organic.
I buy organic.
Me too.
Best all things fruits. For building energy.
If your stomach is strong, the coconut oil or coconut flake is really good. The saturated fat is really good energy. It's probably the best.
So what would you use that on? The coconut flake.
I ate a lot of fruits and dark chocolate.
I like my chocolate.
Yeah, dark chocolate. Dark chocolate.
But I mean food wise, because you wouldn't want to eat a lot of chocolate.
I don't eat
it.
No.
Look,
like for my son who likes to exercise a lot and sweet.
If you use a lot of energy, it's okay to eat oats or a little rice or quinoa.
Chemo.
Yeah.
I do that. I couldn't survive without having to do a heavy workout. There'd be no way. They run out of energy or strength.
Probably faster challenge.
I do.
Or starchy. Sweet potato.
I do eat that.
But the potatoes has toxins.
High glycemic index, too.
Oh, so high. Yeah. So I don't recommend it. I love sweet potatoes and pumpkins.
Squash.
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 Yeah.
In terms of, some people are fast metabolizers.
Right.
Yeah.
And some people are slow metabolizers.
Yeah. DNA, like Japanese are, most of Japanese are slow metabolizer. Most of the white people is faster than Japanese. Also, epigenetics. And the DNA controls a lot, but also the environment affects some genes. Gene expression, the environment affects, so...
Does not increasing your exercise increase your metabolism?
Yeah, that's good. And so, if you make muscle, then easy to metabolize energy. If you sleep well, the cortisol level down, so easy to metabolize.
For people who are fast metabolizers and are exercising, what would you recommend to keep the energy level low?
Saturated fat, such as butter or coconut oil, is very good. Also, it's okay to eat carbs, such as pumpkin, sweet potatoes. Depends on the situation, just before you begin to soccer game, the food is easy to digest and get energy. 3 hours before soccer game, rice is also okay to digest and absorb. Depends on the situation, but generally speaking, the fruit is easy to digest and get energy. Easy to get energy because of fruit has a lot of food enzymes.
Can you get, what would it take to get your license back? For here?
It's too much. I'm already 47. I'm too tired to do night shift. I was an endoscopologist, especially colon and stomach. I really love to operation by endoscopy. But I also searched the way change the diet or lifestyle. It's easier to be healthy. I also treat a lot of diabetes people, hypertension people. I explain change diet to them, but I didn't have enough time. In Japan, the doctor was so busy, and just 5 minutes for one patient. I couldn't explain well, but change diet is easier to treat. The prevention is easier than treatment. I'm always thinking how to explain the right way. Now I have a lot of time to study. My ideal doctor make a diagnosis, just see and listen. Treat, explanation is the best way, not prescription drugs or not operation. So that is my ideal doctor. So I want to improve such skill more and more. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.